they do say that bad luck goes in threes. As you can see, I got 3 miles from home this morning and lost third gear. Everything else selects okay. I'll reverse as well. Third. So it could be several things. It could be synchro springs that have slipped out. It's a very common Land Rover fault, something they never really addressed. It could also be a selector fault. It could be something jammed in the selector fork in there. I've even heard of like a stone flying up. I mean, how unlucky is that, landing in the third gear selector? That would then resist its movement. Seems unlikely. I suspect it's something deeper in the gearbox, so we've got to take the floor up, remove the transmission tunnel, and then we'll find out if we're getting the gearbox out. So I've removed the overdrive bracket, just left the linkage in place for now. I've been having a little bit of a clean up around the top cover that we've got to remove. It goes back to about there. So I can now remove the retainers for the detent springs, which keep the selectors in the positions once you've selected them, the gear you want. It's important to clean around something like this when you're going to remove it, so you don't drop a load of muck down inside. So we'll have a look. See if it's terminal. If so, then we'll carry on stripping it down, ready to get the box out. So I've now exposed the selector levers, removing the detent springs first. You can then lift the cover off, leaving the ball bearings in place. So the next job is to retrieve those carefully. And then, if necessary, we can lift out the selectors and hopefully see a bit more, because at the moment there's nothing obviously wrong. Well, it looks very much like I found the source of all the trouble. What we're looking at here is a synchronizer hub for the third and fourth gear. If you look at the synchronizer hub in the middle of the picture, look to the right of it, you can see the sort of coffin shaped splines. Beneath that, a little machined shaft. Underneath that, there should be a flat spring. What happens when you lose those is the hub becomes off center. You can run with it for a while sometimes, which I think we have been, because I drained synchro springs out when I first changed the oil on it. Eventually you'll lose third gear, you can lose fourth as well, so unfortunately it's time to pull the gearbox out. And that confirms it is indeed a synchro spring. So just to make what I've shown you a little bit clearer is the good old Haynes manual. Here is the third and fourth gear synchro unit. So you can see this piece in the middle has to slide between the two cones. Three springs, one, two, and three. If you lose one, that becomes off center. If you go back to the, I think it's the first series gearbox video, I think that's shown in there. That was a fault on the box I've taken apart. You can see that here is that unit there, right at the front of the box. So it's something I could repair. Could take the box out, pull the synchro unit out, but really, having done all the work, I might as well just replace it with an overhauled unit. Well, that's enough today. Just got to empty the toolbox and then we're done. just taken the very front piece off the transmission tunnel. It should have little plastic clips like you can see over there, only someone's used they put a nut behind each one, so I had the devil's own job getting all of that off. So I'll have to get the proper thing to put it back. Either that will make these round and put a riv nut in, it's probably a good compromise. So the seat box is ready to lift out. Just need to get ourselves a gearbox.